Hi everyone, thank you for taking your time today. We will spend next 30 minutes to an hour on this webinar. Before that, probably myself and Vijay will introduce ourselves. My name is Channa Ganeshan. I'm a global practice head for ServiceNow non-IT workflows inside Wipro. In slides, you will come to know what is non-IT workflow means. And I've been in the IT industry for almost 25 years and close to last 10 years been into ServiceNow as my journey, and that's about my background. So once again, my name is Channa Ganeshan. Nice meeting you all. Vijay, want to introduce?
Thanks, guys. I'm Vijay Anand. I head the delivery for ServiceNow non-IT application in Wipro. I too have around 20 plus of years of experience in IT industry, and around 7 to 8 years I'm into ServiceNow, and played different roles in my past, and currently I have the delivery in Wipro. Thanks, over to you, Channa. In meanwhile, we will cover other topics going forward.
Cool. In the interest of time, so let me take you through a few slides on how ServiceNow is disrupting the market currently, and how you can also become a citizen developer to reap the benefits of this disruption through Topcoder is what we're going to talk about in the further slides. In the post-COVID era, companies are very eager to accelerate their digital transformation journey, right? This is leading to adoption of cloud-based solutions which can connect enterprise departments to improve user experience and support self-service through automations and artificial intelligence. So in a way, ServiceNow is one such platform that promotes rapid innovation through its workflows to make organizations fast and agile in responding to changing market expectations, right? If you look at this one slide, that will make you understand, right, how it's all getting benefited across the globe. In any typical organizations, there will be multiple departments such as sales, finance, IT, marketing, procurement, legal, etc. Right. Each department will have its own set of systems. They could be systems like SAP, Oracle, Salesforce, or any homegrown systems or on-premise systems that you talk about. That they work across the departments. So let us assume that we are onboarding a customer into a system. In a typical scenario, he or she has to go through multiple approvals, like legal approval, finance approval, IT approvals, etc. And in the post onboarding scenario, the customer might have multiple queries, which might involve marketing, sales, or any of these departments. In the current scenario, most of the organizations are facing challenges to answer these customer queries or orchestrate the process, like customer onboarding, which involves multiple departments, right? So this is where ServiceNow will play a major role. It will act as a single source of the truth, or a single pane of the glass. You call it as it will be a single system that can connect to multiple customer landscape systems, having the integrations. It also provides intuitive user experience with the multiple omni channels, right? Such as mobile, self-service portals, any communication channel that you use today. It could be your Slack, WhatsApp, or Teams, right? So ServiceNow has a ability and capable to that you can use this as an interface to talk with ServiceNow. It has a powerful knowledge base, which empowers the the agents who are helping you to solve your queries, or it could be your tickets or cases. It also has a artificial intelligence to automate, to auto assign. Example, you know, a ticket is coming to the system, right? The intelligence will check it up, auto assigning to the particular agent. It has an option of redirecting the approvals and workflows to orchestrate the process, right? In a way, I you know, ServiceNow has an ability that I can talk to any daughter system, that your Accenture system, assume that your Oracle box is down, I can connect to that box and then orchestrate and then restart it, and then come back and say, you know, hey, you know, I solved your, you know, problem. So in a way, if you look at, you know, so this is where, you know, so ServiceNow fits into solving all your needs today, right? In this slide was one of the challenge. So ServiceNow helps you to address multiple challenges, right? Whether it is IT, customer, or employee, you know, so it will act as a service domain, or there is an option to create, you know, your own citizen workflows, right? Using the App Engine capability, you know, as you can see that, you know, it will act as a system of action on the top, on connecting to any of your system of records in the bottom. It could be like an example I was talking in the previous slide. It could be your Oracle, it could be your ERP system, it could be any of your legacy systems, or HCM tools or CRM, right? You'll have different types of systems for all your the transformation needs. So ServiceNow will play a top layer, can connect to all these guys and wire up, and then provide a better service delivery to all your stakeholders, such as your IT stakeholder, your customers, your employees, right? So you could have observed, like, you know, we have been always focusing about customers. Now the trend is, yeah, why not employees as well? So that is how this, all this innovation and adaptive model of ServiceNow is getting into the industry, where everybody is moving towards ServiceNow, right? In a way, you know, I get everything in one single system, act as a single, you know, one single source of the truth by connecting to all your dots in the bottom, right? They otherwise your things are working in silos, right? Now I have everything connected, and then, you know, I have ServiceNow as a one system that can talk to all these 10 or 100 things in the bottom, right? And get my data exchange. So ServiceNow can act as a provider, ServiceNow can act as a consumer, right? You can build your own workflows, you can orchestrate the thing. So there are multiple, you know, so it comes with, you know, tons of, you know, capabilities inside a platform team. So getting into the next slide, you know, we talked about why ServiceNow, what is inside ServiceNow as a quick overview. Now let us look at what is adoption of ServiceNow, why everybody is talking about ServiceNow. So ServiceNow has been adopted by almost 80% of Fortune 500 companies, and there is a strong client base of, you know, 6,900 global enterprise customers with 99% of renewal rate, right? In a way, you can see the potential market and then opportunities for people like us, right? So ServiceNow's aspiration to become a $10 billion company, which will open up at least 40 billion worth of opportunities for service providers like Wipro. So citizen developers will play a key role in fulfilling the talent demands, and then and top coder being a leading platform for crowdsourcing will serve as a key filler in Wipro ServiceNow journey, right? That's about this slide. And if you look at another set of discussion on or points on ServiceNow. As you can see, all leading analysts have rated ServiceNow among the leaders, right? The trend is to expect to continue for next 5 to 10 years, right? In a way, right? There is a huge opportunities and potential for ServiceNow because everybody talks about ServiceNow, right? Though there are multiple, competitors, you know, workflow agents, like, you know, there are tools, you know, which I don't want to name, but ServiceNow is becoming a a no-code low-code platform or a platform of platforms or a platform of choice for anything, right? So that's about the analyst rating on ServiceNow. And how to become a citizen developer, right? So this is the core agenda of this call. So far whatever I've been discussing, probably would have, you know, popped out an option, you know, why not, you know, we get into ServiceNow and quickly grab the opportunity and become a citizen developer, right? So it's so easy to be part of that, you know. In a way, I can say, like, you know, the specialty of ServiceNow is that it's a low code, no code platform, and it's very easy to learn and implement, you know, anything for, you know, any customers. Like we have been talking about the three workflows, right? ID, customer, employee, and there's an option of creating your own workflow, right? You know, you can quickly modernize the thing. You know, there is a legacy Java application. It's been so pain to manage that, right? Or a lot of issues to manage that particular tool. I can quickly build that in ServiceNow in no time, right? So that is how you can see ServiceNow as a spot of your career journey as well, right? So how do I become a citizen developer? All you need to do is register yourself in developer.servicenow.com to create your own account and procure your own personal development instance where you can play a lot and times, right? You can do configure, customize, a lot of things are available. You know, ServiceNow provides you an option of not only configuration of the things that customer is looking out, you can also customize, right? On the existing out of the box workflows, as well as, like I said, you can also build your own workflows. So there is a dedicated citizen developer program available for you as a self-learning choice, and that is where you can begin with, you know, to become a citizen developer team, right? So we will be able to share all these links to you guys, and here are the multiple options available to sharpen your ServiceNow skills, and you know, you can go from there. I think with that, I took 15 minutes to quickly give you why ServiceNow, what is there inside ServiceNow, and how do we get there to become a citizen developer. So with that note, any questions? I will also let Vijay speak about the challenges that we typically post in top coder or further things, anything to do with the ServiceNow. Vijay, over to you.
Yeah, thanks, Chana. Yeah. So well covered, Chana. You have covered the citizen program well. So citizen program is very unique and the most powerful for any new developers. They can actually get their own instance kind of stuff, and you need to keep that live. So that is most important. You need to keep it live, otherwise it goes off and you will not be able to get the code whatever you have customized. So please keep in mind, after you register, you get your own instance. So ensure that you keep alive by working on it on a daily basis. That is most important. Next is, we already have launched a few of the challenges for you to taste how the challenges would be in ServiceNow. So please do participate, and lot more to come in. As you all know, ServiceNow is becoming very hot in the market, and resource challenges every company is facing. And we have a lot of opportunities. There are a lot of opportunities to earn and also learn ServiceNow. So I again welcome you to be part of the community and earn and learn ServiceNow and help us to help you on this journey. That's it from my side. Any questions, we can take it up. If you have any specific questions on ServiceNow, what are the challenges? How do we do it in Wipro? Any questions if you have around ServiceNow or anything, we'll be happy to answer you guys. Jesse, they will be able to ask questions or it will be on a chat.
I do see someone posed a question. Is content availability limited for some specific tasks? No, I don't think there is a limitation. If you are a outsider, you know, you will have pretty much every documents available. There's docs.service.com. It is available for public, where you can read and understand every bits of ServiceNow and its modules. There's a community.servicenow.com. There is a store.servicenow.com. It's all publicly available. And getting your own ServiceNow instance through developer.servicenow.com will enable you to provide certain materials available. But if you are part of some organization where, you know, for example, if you are part of Wipro, Wipro as a partners.serviceportal.com, where we will have multiple other choices, like, you know, getting into some self-learning options to procure some accreditations, like type of certifications, right? So those choices are limited for externals, but if you get into your partners portal, yeah, so you will get plenty of these options as well. The question was from Robinson.
Right. And also to add to that, the docs.servicenow has got tons of documents which will provide you a guide, and also you'll be able to do everything and understand ServiceNow in and out.
Yeah. Got it. So I see one more question. What is the most interesting ServiceNow project you have gotten to be involved with? So, yeah. Everything is interesting, right? Every customer comes with the tons of their own requirement and expectations. In a way, I'll take a couple of examples. Let us think out of the box, right? For one of the healthcare customer, we built claims automation using ServiceNow. We are also working on one of the consumer company on the rebate process using ServiceNow, using the customer workflow. And using same workflow, customer workflow, we are working for one of the technology company where it requires almost 230 integrations are required to be done to enable the channel partner program, you know. So every of their channel partners have their own set of tools that we have to integrate. Every tool have its own exposed APIs and the data exchanges between ServiceNow and these tools. We had to go through these processes and nuts and bolts to get everything all you need in one system, right? That I would say that's one of our major and complex architecture in terms of having 200 plus integrations in single implementation. Nathan, hope that answers your question. Any other questions? So Vijay, do you want to post any typical challenges or example challenges that we post in Top Coder? Talk about that. Recently posted something for SWM and stuff, right?
So, right. So recently we did post three of our use cases from a USG customer, actually. So that has been running, and we are yet to get the responses and evaluate them. But very good response, and people are more interested on it. Okay, there is another question. I'm curious about the plugin. Looking forward to learn more here. Any payment, anything, payment integrations?
There is no default payment integration plugin available as per my knowledge, but there are tons of plugins available. But we have done integrations with the things like authorize.net, and then there's one more, some .io, I forget. As long as you have anything to do with exposed APIs, I can use that inside ServiceNow. And ServiceNow has the access control layers also in a way to take care of your security breaches and other things. There are options of converting your the secured fields to encrypted ones. All those possibilities are available. And plugins in general, there are plenty of plugins. There are hundreds of plugins available in ServiceNow. They are specific to certain tools. You know, even we as a company, you know, we also build our own accelerators. Like, you know, we developed a Dropbox plugin. It's ready for publishing them into store. We developed a HelloSign, a digital signature plugin. We also enhanced and kind of extension of a plugin that's already there out of the box for connecting to SAP SuccessFactors. You know, we found some white spaces and we built our own, which can be used for our customers. Right, example, writing employee record by connecting to SAP, which was not available. So we did build that. Likewise, yeah, there are options and integration hub is available. You can quickly use the drag and drop kind of options. You know, it's a visualized workflow engine that you can connect to. Example, your AD integration can be quick and easy. So that's about the plugins, Robinson. What does the low code or low code environment with ServiceNow look like? What are original level of certificate in ServiceNow and how difficult are these they to achieve? Okay. So when I say low code, no code, example in ServiceNow, we have a typical form, a web form. In order to add, you know, additional two fields in the form, you know, in a typical way, if you talk about Java or something, you have to write, tons of lines of code to get that fields to be available, including validation and everything. So in a way, ServiceNow provides an option as a slush bucket that I can quickly move the fields from left to available fields to right hand side. That is one way which is available. Basically, you're picking from your database entity. It's one of the example of low code, no code. Applying a validation on particular fields, ServiceNow provides you an option called UI policies. You know, all about data. You get into data on click, on editor, whatever, you know. So it could be anything, read-only, making read-only field, editable field, all that can be within quick couple of minutes, just right-click and configure those using the platform capabilities, right? An example of low-code, no-code platform. ServiceNow provides you, the workflow designer, where you can open and then you can simply write a plain vanilla English that can eventually become a workflow for you, right? Step one, talk to Vijay. Step two, talk to Robinson. Step three, talk to Nathan. You can configure that in the workflow. Basically, every step, you can also create a task in the system, right? You can automate this workflow. So inside that broken parts, inside that parts of the steps, you can also customize something which is not out of the box on your own, where basically the base flavors of the skills inside ServiceNow is all about, in a way I can say, if you are coming from Java, if you know some Java basics, if you know object-oriented program, for you, ServiceNow is an easy kick. Or in a way, every customization or skills required in ServiceNow, a scripting required in ServiceNow, all about JavaScript-based flavors. Right, so that's about in a way. If you want to talk about no code, low code, example, I wanted to quickly build my service portal. ServiceNow provides you tons of ready-made available widgets where you can quickly drag and drop, and boom, my page is done and ready in 10 minutes. right? And you, on your own interest, if you want to develop your own widgets, which is not there out of the box, or if you want to change something, you need to have AngularJS flavors of skills in order to develop those service portal widgets, right? I think these are the two components when it comes to skills. Otherwise, it's all typical about HTML, style sheet. It's all basics, right? So all you need is JavaScript, HTML, style sheets, and a bit of AngularJS, and then you're all set to go in ServiceNow. And you can call it yourself, you're a supermaster in ServiceNow. Coming to credentials and certifications, the way I would start, like, there is a public citizenship program available. You go through that and complete it, so you will understand the end-to-end high-level overview of ServiceNow. And if you get into partners portal, you know, you will get an opportunity to complete. There are tons of sales and pre-sales accreditations, you know, that will cover you to go through each and every modules in ServiceNow. And there is an option of, you know, procuring some of the micro certifications. Then I would start with you become a certified system admin of ServiceNow is the first step of certification in ServiceNow. And I have certified system admin. I am certified in ITSM implementation specialist. I'm certified in HRSD implementation specialist. And I'm certified, the CAD, you know, certified development application, developer application. So I'm also aiming to become a master at it in ServiceNow. So there are a list of certifications on every application level and module level. So if you talk about IT workflows, you will have ITSM certification, you will have IT OEM certification, you will have ITPM certification, SecOps and GRC. If you talk about CSM, you will have a CSM and FSM certification. If you talk about HRSD, HRSD certification is there. And then for developing any custom solutions, you have to procure a certified developer application developer certification, which is CAD, right? So these are the types of certifications, Nathan. So that answers your question.
Yeah. And one more thing, yeah. Channa, the question also elaborates for the how difficult is that to achieve the certification? So if you could answer that, because you hold a lot of certifications, so you are good to answer that.
What was that, Vijay?
Yeah, so how difficult is to clear and get certified is the question.
Right. I felt a little, end of the day, it's not a rocket science. There are multiple options, you know, there are Quizlets available publicly where you can practice. It's all about, you know, a question with the four choices provided. As long as you understand the core platform, any of these certificates that I've been talking about, it's so easy, right? My 1 year experience, guys, the precious college grads are quickly clearing certifications because they come with the fresh mind, you know. So people like us, you know, sometimes a little confused, but in a way, my first attempt some years back when I was trying to clear my system admin certificate, you know, it took me a week to prepare for an exam. I was a little nervous, but now there are plenty of documentations are available in public where you can go practice on your own. Like I said, there are Quizlets, there are wizards, you know, go to Udemy kind of websites where you can play on these play cards and come back and go for a real exam, right? And it is not so complicated, right? But, you know, as long as you understand the platform, example, what is CMD, what is the core table in ServiceNow, how can you utilize the, you know, the task table, you know, such type of questions. You know, basically, you understand the platform at the architecture level. That is the basis that, you know, you will start the program, right? So it is not so complicated to get that understanding. You know, so it's all about your interest. But nowadays, ServiceNow as a product is evolving. There are plenty of opportunities and plenty of, you know, documents and materials are available where you can quickly pick up those and then become a certified ServiceNow expert. And the trend is ServiceNow. Everybody talks about ServiceNow. ServiceNow themselves conducting, they already enabled in UK. ServiceNow is one of their subject part of the education syllabus in their curriculum. right? So you, they will give you ServiceNow degree basically, right? Part of the program, and by the time you come out of the college, you will be a ServiceNow expert, right? In a way, things are moving like that. So imagine, so ServiceNow is putting a lot of such efforts to take their path into become a $10 billion company, and companies like Wipro are heavily competing that, you know, even we have aspiration of becoming a $1 billion practice inside Wipro, right? So we are heavily thinking through all these aspects. Hope that answers and gives you more content.
We have one more question. Can it be deployed locally from CLI in case offline?
I think CLI long back, I have to recall my mind, there used to be a SVLI instances where it provides you to do a self-learning stuff. I'm not sure if it's still available, such options. I'll have to find that out for offline, Robinson. Good. Any other questions? I hope the session was really useful. You know, you could have got a little or maybe at high level overview or a glance on why everybody is talking about ServiceNow, right? What is there inside, right? And how does it helps for the industry, you know, for the customers or employees, right? And what kind of problem that ServiceNow can solve. And ServiceNow, in a way you can call it as, it's a service delivery tool, a digital modernization tool where you can build anything, or it, you call it as a system of action for all your system of records, right? It's a single source of the truth. These are the words that, you know, you remember. Why ServiceNow? What is ServiceNow, right? You can automate anything and everything, it's possible. And ServiceNow, like I was talking about skills, JavaScript or Angular or whatever, it is not limited. I come from a Java background. Sometimes I go think out of the box. Some of the processes I develop outside ServiceNow and use them, you know, as and when I needed to automate some of the processes. Example, you know, we developed the OCI kind of capabilities, taking a paper to digital. So basically I send my scanned copy of my, for example, my passport. I want to convert that to a digital. So we built some tools outside where it will change that conversion and then supplies the data back to ServiceNow. So think through, you know, imagine you can expand any types of wings out of ServiceNow that can build your out of possible solutions and automations for any of the customer needs team. Think okay. What's next?
What's next after the skill building and UHT challenges? Yeah, a lot more challenges to come, and we have many more challenging projects which we have taken. Those challenges will be shortly posted, and you will have good learning and also earning from it. And we look forward your support to complete us with good quality in quick time. Task work and customer challenges for those who successfully do this initial challenges. So Nathan, what is the last phrase?
I think he's talking about the challenges that you want to bring in the site.
Okay.
Talent as a service is our gig work program. ServiceNow is challenges. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. All right. This is a talent as a service.
Okay. Any other questions? What else I can talk about ServiceNow? Yeah, ServiceNow, it's up in the sky, right? Everyone is transforming from from even we have resources who are migrating from their X skills to ServiceNow in quick time, right? Even I'm one of the examples. So I moved from Java to ServiceNow, right, some years back. I feel so comfortable and easy handling ServiceNow team.
Yeah. So all this while we were talking only about how the developer does the work, and it is not only that ServiceNow focuses on the developer front. They also concentrate on the users or the agents who use the tool. So a lot of new inventions, new options, user experience have been built in ServiceNow. One example I would quote is agent workspace. So it is an amazing experience for agents to, in a single pane, they can have a clear view of their day-to-day work. So likewise, very good options. So once after this webinar, I'm sure you guys will look into ServiceNow and learn more. So that is one thing. And on the portal side, for the end user experience also, a lot of options available, customization possible. It gives really a good service portal, how a website can be created. In many companies, service portal itself, a company's intranet portal. Like that, it can be built with a lot of customization.
Yeah.
So excellent yeah. Tool.
Choices like virtual agent, right? A virtual agent will help you on yourself. You know, you can find your answers that you need. We recently built a application called FieldX, which helps the post-sale service automation. Example, you know, as a customer, I called for my washing machine to be repaired or serviced. Then agent walks into my place, right? And he takes a look, but he's unable to solve the problem. We provide an option called augmented reality based solution, where agent can take the remote help from the super expert of, you know, who can help him to assist fixing the problem. Rather, the agent came in unable to fix, and then walking back, and then, you know, so having another guy coming in, there's SLA breach, right? Rather, how do we solve this problem? You think through one way that agent takes care of this, or during this pandemic situation, I don't like someone walking into my home. How do I solve this problem on my own? Is there a way somebody can help me solving this issue? Yeah, the mobile application provided, you know, using that augmented reality, I can solve the my washing machine problem, right? Taking the remote help from the agents. So there are plenty like that you can talk about. You know, there is no limitation on ServiceNow. Like, you know, we talked about OCR capabilities. AMLs are a lot. You know, we also worked with IBM Watson as a chatbot. Their NLU is super powerful. You know, any language accent can quickly convert, right? I can speak my text. I can speak and convert my text too, so easy. ServiceNow has a very powerful NLU on that. We have done tons of integrations with Google and Alexa, right? All this, you know, example, Alexa, what is the status of my case? It will answer you by connecting to ServiceNow, right? Yeah. So all that is possible, team.
So mobile application, virtual agent, everything can be on one device. On the go, if somebody wants to know the status of their tickets, it can be done. It can be integrated with Google Assist. It's so simple to do it as well.
Yeah. So, yeah. So, So there are plenty of challenges that we are thinking to pose them in the top coder. So keep watch for it. Get yourself motivated to get into ServiceNow. Industry is so warm. Get in, move on, and we'll post some of the challenges quickly. You know, could be starting with how do you automate some of the things. You know, so Good. I think we're good to go. I don't see any further questions.